De-Microsoftification. Wait, let me say that again. De-Microsoftification. What does that mean, and why did I fly to the ends of the earth to talk about it? And who is this company that's pushing this de-Microsoftification, and why are they doing it? And who were the other tech YouTubers involved? Oh, and what is all this new hardware, and why is this server filled with beer? I'll try to answer these questions and more, but I'm not sure I'll be able to explain this one.
Delicious.
I'll try my best. To answer these questions, I think we need to rewind just a little bit. 45 Drives is a company out of Nova Scotia, Canada, almost as far east as you can go in North America. You might recognize the Stornator from one of the many times Linus helped set up storage systems for other YouTubers, including Marquez Brownlee, iJustine, and more. 45 Drives still builds the Stornator along with many other new products we'll talk about later, but their main business is building enterprise storage solutions. These solutions are built on an open platform and with open source, and they've really been pushing to get Ceph, Rocky Linux, and Proxmox into the enterprise. This year, they hosted a creator summit, which I was invited to, and the topic this year was de-Microsoftification, which in the co-founder Doug's words is,
"And Microsoft is a metaphor for all things proprietary and looking at things open as the alternative of it."
Other tech YouTubers that you might recognize were also invited, and we all made the trip from all over the US up to Nova Scotia.
How do you know we're going somewhere weird? That's right.
Full disclosure, 45 Drives did pay for my travel and accommodations for this trip. However, this video is not sponsored by them. Before we gave our talks, we were given a tour of 45 Drives, which included the main office where most of the staff works, the studio where they filmed the 45 Drives content, and the lab where they test and develop new products. Here you can find some fully developed products that are currently in production, but you can also see some early prototypes. The HL4 and the HLA are two new products that are being developed in their home lab lineup. These storage machines are built with most of the same materials as their larger counterparts, but have been shrunk down to fit on a desk rather than being rack mounted. It's a pretty interesting take on a NAS. It's an open platform running open source software, and the case can do a cool trick by loosening a couple of hand screws and it opens up like a clamshell, letting you easily service the machine. They are also working on this new 1U 4-bay and a 2U 8-bay storage server that has a toolless and caddyless design. You can remove and insert the drives pretty easily, again, without caddies because 45 Drives despises them. I can really appreciate the engineer that's going into this. The Stornado F2, which is a 32-drive NVMe storage server, also has its own take on caddyless drives with this push and pop design. Then there's this machine called the Proxinator, which is a 1U server built for virtualization and runs Proxmox virtual environment. And next to that is a server which lets you install a few full-size PCI Express devices. I can see this being used as a self-hosted AI machine with all of that space for a graphics card. There are quite a few clients they are producing too. There's a passively cooled work and home client that has no fans and is one big heat sink that seems to be targeting general business use or used as a remote client to connect to a remote desktop. There's also a few stations which are actively cooled, which can accommodate a full-size GPU for CAD work or even gaming. Oh, as an aside, a bunch of us use these workstations for a LAN gaming party. They installed PopOS for the operating system and also Steam, and we played CSGO and Halo for a few hours. It was a ton of fun, and the games ran surprisingly well on Linux, but back to the lab. They are also prototyping an even smaller, passively cooled machine for light duty but critical workloads like digital signage. I can imagine this machine mounted on the back of a monitor. You might be wondering, how the heck do they crank out all of these machines? Well, 45 Drives has an advantage because they are also a manufacturing company, and that manufacturing company, Protocase, is just a hop, skip, and a jump away. Next door at Protocase, they can do mass custom, meaning that they can produce a lot of custom parts in any quantity for many different customers. We got to see how some of this works, and it's really incredible and inspiring to see everything that's going on inside of this building. They can turn an idea into a prototype and then into a final product in just a few hours. A perfect example of this is the Beerinator. Yes, a Beerinator. It's a rack-mounted Stornator converted to a refrigerator that can keep your beer cold. This was an idea that Jeff from Craft Computing kicked around, and 48 hours later, they had a working prototype that stored beer, kept it cold, and had a great-looking faceplate. But one of the coolest and most unique things they are prototyping is this solution for MSPs. The idea is that you can stack and mix and match different components, like a PSU with compute, storage, and other components. This makes it dead simple to expand in the future. Just pick up another unit and stack it on top. Power and data are passed through to the unit, and there aren't any cables to manage. It's an interesting take on stackable computing without the need for a rack. We'll see how this goes in the future. So many cool things were going on in the lab, but it was time for the creator-led talks. These talks were all inspired by the theme of De-Microsoftification. Keep in mind that De-Microsoftification is a metaphor for proprietary enterprise solutions. And I personally respect Microsoft as a company in many ways, but after hearing the challenge from other small businesses about privacy, forced updates, and non-value-added UI changes, gives me a new perspective of Windows when it comes to running a business. This was the tone for a majority of the talks. The talks ranged from people switching to Linux for their daily driver, to tips for switching to Linux, to open source solutions that you can use today. I focused on the challenges and benefits of switching to open source solutions and highlighted some of the alternatives when it comes to client management without Microsoft Active Directory. We heard from the customers and some of the 45 Drive staff. We also shared these topics on a live stream from the Alexander Graham Bell Museum, which was such a unique experience. It was cool to step back and think that we streamed our talk over the internet in the same building where some of the first telephone prototypes were held. So cool. One thing that was clear from all of the talks and all of the prototypes is that 45 Drives is going headfirst into Linux on the client. They aren't just talking about it, they're actually doing it internally and will help their customers switch over too. And on top of that, they're backing open source projects like Rocky Linux and even Ceph to ensure that these open source projects continue to live on. But it wasn't all tech and open source, although that was the theme throughout the week. We got to meet lots of people in the company and even some from the community. A guy I met last year who engineered the 2.5 Caddy solution for the Stornator created these dark mode in real life glasses for me and I was totally floored. They turned out so good. Thanks, Mark. And it wasn't only about 45 Drives and their staff. It was also about meeting some of my favorite tech creators and getting to build deeper relationships and get to know them outside of the digital world. We got to do things like go sailing, or play Ceph Jenga with a live cluster, randomly hop on a live stream, travel around Nova Scotia, and even stop by a convenience store at midnight to try a Nova Scotia favorite, Moon Mist ice cream. To sum it all up, I think that de-Microsoftification, or switching to open source solutions, can be done with proper planning, setting expectations, and working through the pain points. And although Linux desktop distributions are not perfect, like any operating system, for the right customer base, I think they offer stability, security, and predictability that most businesses are looking for. I was humbled to be invited back to the Creator Summit this year and excited to see different perspectives that others faced with open source solutions and Linux as a desktop. I am also grateful to be part of this awesome community and I'm thankful to everyone who made this possible. I think it's about time I tried the Linux challenge as a developer to see if it can work for me. Maybe soon. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.